we'll talk about different places on the SkyMapper group. So I just want to preface this with, I don't do many presentations, so if I start something really, really fast, because if you're coming in the element of something that might try to slow down, I'd say it's probably about the same stuff. So the other fellow has explained SkyMapper before, so I'm not going to go too long and explain what it does. This is a quick idea of SkyMapper, go to the sky and find possible supernova or possible active stars. And then a couple of months later, they go back to the same position and take another image, and then compare the different images and decide whether that object that was very, very bright from the sky is a possible supernova or possible alien from the ground over. Once we have this different image, we have a lovely little scenario, and again, try to decide whether this is perhaps a bad reference or whether it's an actual object that we're seeing. If we do think it's an actual object, we will do some follow-up symmetry on the object on that screen of the sky, and that will then be part of the active stages in this project as well. Once you have the active stages, we will then do some follow-up spectroscopy on that to try to classify either supernova or alien or some other supernova-like object, and that will become a classified supernova-like object. The other thing I'll go through is that this is very important in the presentation, so just remember active tangents and classified supernova-like objects. The final step is to take these objects and upload them to connect to the screen in any survey. Obviously, and that's where my project comes in. I've written a essentially good code that will automatically upload the objects to the survey. I think about a little bit later, but first I'm going to give you guys an idea about what the screen in any survey is. So, that's a very, very nice thing. Basically, lots and lots of objects. It's got both active transients and classified supernova-like objects within it. There are 34 groups at the moment that are uploading these objects to the server, with over 5,000 objects uploaded so far. And of these 34 groups, there are written dots in this one that my project is writing. The reason that people are uploading on these supernova to this server is, well, apparently, the specific list that came out could be three objects. So, SN from 11SW, PCF 11SY, and PS1 11BM. So, these are three different classifications in three different papers of the exact same object. And none of the groups in the world being the same thing. And there are multiple times this has happened, but actually, one I believe was a six classifications and five papers of the same object. This is obviously a few breaks of scientific time, different breaks, so telescope time to get through it, and the time to get to do the spectroscopy. So, having a way to make sure that we don't read the old work allows us to get more time to get across it. So, in the future, we're going to take and reduce the possibility that we're reading what we've already done, save time to get there, and allow us to save some time to get complete as well. That's also, however, it's very, very difficult to actually upload these supernovae. It takes up a lot of time for SkyMapper screens. We have to specify these supernovae as well. This is a few templates from the webpage that both of them go to do the uploading. And one of the main issues is that you can only upload one object at a time. You have to bring like 600 reports to every single object. And that's very efficient and works a lot of time. So, what my API does, what my robot does, is it really automatically does this for the SkyMapper screen. So it actually looks through the TMS for the main server to find the kind of upload from the SkyMapper is already done. If we're not going to do that, we're going to upload our own database with the same information. If not, we're actually going to generate that report all by ourselves. We're going to give it all the relevant information. We can upload both these active tangents that I pulled up for, and we can actually classify the active tangents as whatever supernova-like objects they are. And this will all be done automatically with my new community input. So, let's now the people over at TMS do actually provide some sample code that's provided in both PHP and Python that I have never coded in PHP, but I'm using Python. And it does three main things. Once you've built the report, you can send it over to the TMS people. They will then take more written support that tries to make sure that your object actually exists and see other things, and then they'll give you a report ID. This is unique classifying for the report, which you can go through later on. If you don't have to do that, you can go back can get the CNS name. So every single object, the same name, so that I can give its own name to make sure that all the names are, you know, have the same name as the name. And then we update them in the database to keep that name so we know where I'm talking about. I do find this doesn't do some of the main issues that you're having, so it doesn't actually build the report for you, and that's the most complex thing with stuff. It also doesn't allow us to specify the object, and it doesn't allow us to upload any individual text to that invoice. So, this is what my notes do, and it's slightly more complicated. I'm going to go through all of this later in this presentation, but just as a quick breakdown, it puts some data from our SkyMapper database. We then start the address and reports that we need to upload, or by itself, with no input needed. Or then, start the report to make sure it's actually valid and isn't going to cause any errors within the CNN server. It's going to check if the object is somehow already on the CNN, which means that, again, not receiving other people's data. And then it will do the same step that the given table do. It will upload the report to the CNN that we need. So we'll talk about this part here, just the generation of reports, because as I said, that's the most time-consuming. It's also going to be the most complicated part. So there are two main things that are happening here. We are actually uploading images and uploading spectra of the object, and that we can do the same thing in another step. But the most important bit is this loop over here, and that where the way the thing is working, you can't upload a supernova by itself. You have to upload it as an active statement and then specify it as a supernova. So the difference here is that if something to make sure we've uploaded it as an active statement first, if you have the state and specify it, you then otherwise you need to upload it as an active statement and then go back and specify it later. So the two things that we need to include in this report are life extension, destination, the last one protection, the source of use, and other stuff like that. This is all provided by SkyMapper, and it's simply passing the stuff from one dictionary to the other. Which is very similar, very interesting. The next step is we want to set up some images, some files, and stuff like that. And this is a bit of an interesting thing to get working, because we have some documentation to start passing the images, and essentially like this. Here is your CNS file name and the binary data that you're trying to upload. It will then give you this name to that file, so make sure you have uploaded the zip file, and you add that into the report. Basically, like the syntax or anything like that, the Python code, as I said, doesn't actually have this information. So I have to learn what it means to look into the CSV file and then find out the syntax in that, which is a lot easier. And this is essentially getting the end. So, regular dictionary, the index, and the binary, and the name. And that is kind of the next step that we set this project up for. The next step is to take up the source that we generated and set it for validity. When I said validity, I mean that it has the right syntax, so that's looking at from what it's looking at. I've been doing the necessary questions, so I've been looking at life extension, destination, name, state, stuff like that. And that just doesn't actually have valid values in them. So, life extension can only be in housing, it's not going to be called a decimal degree, it can't be some other number that you expect to touch. That's a kind of important statement. The next step is the timing of the goal, which is where we actually set the CNS to make sure that we're not trying to re-upload something that's already been put up there. So, we're only going to do that in two steps. The first thing you do is you set and see the CNS for any object. That is within 10 archetypes of your object, then this diagram allows you to see what I've done in the middle. So this is a list of all the objects within 10 archetypes of our own. We're going to go through that list, and if any of the objects are within 5 archetypes of our object, we say they're actually the same object, so we probably shouldn't be uploading the same object. So that is a reference, 5 archetypes, it's about 10 pixels on the SkyMapper image. The final step, as I mentioned before, is exactly the same as it was with the code that we're given. You take the report, upload it, they will then send the report token back, and just to give us the name that we need, and we can update it on the database from that. So that was essentially just using the same code that we gave. Now, so far, we do have this extensive system implemented, and this is already gone through some of the you can also listen to uploading text files that include that the data survey has already started to upload, so we upload that data that is existing information, and as soon as upload to other we get about 10 objects each day that we want to upload or classify, and we'll be able to do this automatically with no movement at all. That's what we're going to do just in the final few weeks of this project, is go through the code and make it all fully documented, as well as provide a PDF alongside. And this will allow, if anything needs to be changed, this will allow it to be more simple to change the code as well. And I believe that's everything I have here. If there are any questions, please call me up. On the object, if I go back to I can get the notes that I was in like the purple circle that is moving in this circle. It kind of depends not if it's finding one that can get any single thing in the purple circle at all. After I'm having to use a lot of physics getting these objects, so we're usually not close to the circle together. If an object happens to be close by, you might get 3 or 4, but you never get more than 5 or 6 objects within the same area. And of that, first you only need to do one object to introduce that data, and that's going to be if you're uploading the same object. So maybe you have 5 steps you need to do to make sure that you're able to do all the other objects. Yeah, that's right. You're going to be so proud of it. That's not just a step of the portal. We actually look at their data to see if there's anything we can improve into their data and to duplicate to their data to update our database. It depends how close they are. If they're a measurable distance across, it's going to actually pick it up. They might both be in the perfect section, which means the first and after is quite a step, but hopefully they won't be too close. One thing that we can say is also secondly, of the observations and of the non-detections, and there are still options that are close to that exact, so yeah, that's really important, and of course, that is what we're going to do. Thank you. Thank you so much.